Infinity Train Season 2 is a season of television that not a lot of people talk about. It's not the season that started it all, like Season 1. It's not Owen Dennis's magnum opus, like Season 3. And it's not awful, like Season 4. So Season 2 is probably the Infinity Train season that gets talked about the least out of the 4. So let's change that. Infinity Train Season 2 executes its message better than any other story out there, and I'm tired of pretending it doesn't. So let's look at how this tiny cartoon managed to handle its message in a perfect way. The first and very obvious thing the season does is integrate the message into the arc of the main character. This is the most common way stories show the audience their message. So Infinity Train Season 2 is about MT, who is the reflection of someone else. The message of the season is pretty clear. Don't let anyone tell you who you are or what you should do. You are who you choose to be, and you should always do what you think is right. But you have to accept every part of yourself to be able to have that freedom. And the audience learns that that's the message of the season, because MT learns the importance of that message. The protagonist of your story is almost always going to be the character the audience is the most invested in. So a good way to teach the audience something is by making the protagonist learn the thing you want the audience to remember. It's very important to make the audience care about your protagonist, because otherwise they won't care about your message. But as soon as the audience cares about the protagonist, they will also care about what the protagonist learns. Let's look at MT as an example. They fight for their freedom for the entire season. They don't want to be a reflection, they want to be a person. Eventually, they're able to escape the train and live their own life because of the fact that they are a reflection. MT learns that it's important to accept every part of yourself to be able to be who you want to be. The audience will remember this because they were with MT the whole time. It feels like we, as the audience, went through everything they went through, so we learned the same thing. The second thing Infinity Train Season 2 does to make its message clear is introducing a character with a counter-ideology to the message. This means that the story has a character that is a symbol for the opposite of the message. This will most likely be an antagonist. Characters like these lose in the end, because they don't see the importance of the message of the story. Infinity Train Season 2 has multiple characters like this, but let's look at Grace as an example. Grace thinks Nulls shouldn't be able to make their own decisions, and she also thinks Jesse should do what she says instead of doing what he wants. She eventually loses both Jesse and MT. Jesse eventually got home by doing what he thought was right, instead of just blindly following the group. And MT was able to go home because she made her own choices. So the show proves that its message was correct by showing what happens when you don't believe in the message. Another great example of this is in Puss in Boots. Jack Horner is the only character that doesn't learn that you don't need a wish to be happy, and he gets defeated by the people he pissed off in his quest to find the wish, to prove that you should try to be happy with what you have. The message of the season is also a fundamental part of every character in the season, not just the protagonist and antagonist. A common pitfall of making the message a part of literally everything in your story is that it starts to feel a bit on the nose. But Infinity Train Season 2 found a great way to remedy this. Every character in the season has to learn the message of the season, but they all have to learn different parts of it in different ways. So it's not like every character learns the exact same thing. No, they all have to learn different things that have something to do with the message. Jesse doesn't have to learn to accept every part of him, but he needs to learn that he should make his own choices instead of always following other people. The parasite tries to take Alan Dracula's free will away, but the group helps Alan so that he can make his own choices again. Being able to make your own choices, not always following other people, and accepting who you are very different things, but they're all part of the same message. And because of this, every part of the message feels new and unique, because every character learns a different part of that message. Giving every character their own part of the message also gives the message way more depth, because you get to explore it from so many different angles. The last thing this season does extremely well in terms of message is making the message feel personal. People will always remember your message more when it feels like the message was meant for them. A lot of people have said that Infinity Train Season 2 was a metaphor for people not accepting trans people's new identity because of who they are. So seeing MT finally choose their own name must have been very satisfying for trans people. I know something like this isn't possible with every message, but there's another way to make your message feel personal. leave room for interpretation. The season's ending is a great example of this. Empty calls herself Lake. This is a great moment, because they didn't get to choose what people called them up to this moment. But I think the fact that they call themselves Lake means that they have finally accepted that they will always be a null. But they finally realized that doesn't matter. This is just my interpretation, and I don't think it was intentional, because it clashes pretty hard with the trans metaphor idea. But I really like it because it was my idea. The great thing about interpretations is that they always feel personal, because it's something that you came up with yourself. So if you can't make a message feel like it was meant for certain people, make room for some interpretations, because they will make the message feel more personal too. So if you want your story to have an incredible message like Infinity Train, make sure to integrate the message into the character arc of your protagonist, add a character with a counter ideology to show why your message is important. Make your message part of everything in your story, but make sure to show different parts of your message, and make the message feel personal. I hope you learned something in this video, and I'll see you in the next one. Remember when I said this? I have so much more to say about this season and this show as a whole, but this video is getting real long, so I'll give this season its own video, I promise. Yeah, I didn't really do that, did I? I made a lot of promises in my summer review video, and I'm still planning on making most of the videos I said I was gonna make in this video. The only one I'm probably not gonna make is the Sea Beast video. I have a script for an Arcane video that is pretty much done, I just haven't found the time to give it the final touch. I'm also working on an Infinity Train retrospective. I have teased that video multiple times already, and I want to let you guys know that I'm still working on it. But it probably won't be out until next year, because I'm working on so many projects at the same time. So I hope this video was enough to keep the Infinity Train fans happy. See you in 2 weeks!